We've talked about carbs and tryptophan for stress resistance. Now let's talk about carbs and tryptophan for sleep. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're gonna talk about how carbs and tryptophan can help you sleep by helping you make melatonin. So back in episode 105, we talked about how carbs help get tryptophan into the brain, which helps you make serotonin, and that can contribute to your stress resistance. Well, melatonin is actually made from serotonin. So melatonin, as the signal of darkness and the thing that tells your body that it's time to sleep and that it's time to do all the processes that your body wants to do while you're sleeping, that has very similar practical implications as we talked about in the episode on stress resistance. So to recap, you need to get tryptophan into your brain, but you get tryptophan from protein. And when you eat protein, you get all these other competing amino acids that are all fighting with tryptophan to get into the brain. When you eat carbs, you get a spike of insulin. That insulin brings those competing amino acids into your muscle cells and allows the tryptophan to get into the brain with less competition. A number of people responded to that episode and said, well, doesn't protein stimulate insulin? Yes, protein stimulates insulin, but it stimulates less insulin than carbs do. And the insulin that is stimulated by protein comes with a greater dose of the competing amino acids. So the problem we're trying to solve is that we want more tryptophan, but less of the competing amino acids, and getting the extra insulin from the carbs is what is helping us do that. So getting tryptophan into the brain allows the tryptophan to be converted into serotonin and then down several steps into melatonin. But it doesn't seem to matter when you get the tryptophan into the brain. You just need to get a good chunk of it into the brain on a daily basis. So there are studies, for example, showing that even if you get a dose of carbs at breakfast, that still helps you get tryptophan into the brain so that later at night you can make the melatonin. Now, to get this dose of carbohydrate, I would recommend having whole foods that have a fairly high glycemic index. So not junk food and not things with added sugars, but if you Google glycemic index, you should find a list of high glycemic foods, select from the natural ones. I think the ones that stand out as having a high glycemic index and therefore most helpful in this context, but also being the most nutrient dense, are potatoes, whether they're white potatoes or sweet potatoes. If you're not on a low-carb diet, I don't think it's as important when you consume the carbs because you have more freedom to consume more carbs more of the time. But if you're trying to be conservative with your carbohydrate intake and you're trying to limit how many carbohydrates you consume, then I do think it makes sense to put the carbs into your evening meal, not so much for the reasons discussed in this episode, but because, as I discussed in the last episode, more protein at night tends to wake up signals in your brain that keep you up, whereas more carbohydrate at night tends to dampen those signals. So it does make sense to shift the carbohydrate into the evening meal if you have to be conservative about when you eat it. Now, if you are very conservative with your carbohydrate intake, so much so that you can't really take full advantage of the ideas discussed here. For example, if you're on a ketogenic diet, another way to get tryptophan into the brain away from the competing amino acids is to take a tryptophan supplement on an empty stomach. So start with the labeled dose on, say, you could start with 500 milligrams. You could work your way up over time if you don't have any adverse reactions to that. Take the tryptophan on an empty stomach and take it as far away from other protein as you can. So if you can take it a couple hours away from other protein, that would be great. In terms of when to take it during the day, it doesn't matter so much about morning versus night. It matters more when is it most convenient for you to take it away from the other protein. In other words, depending on your meal frequency, you might find that it's easiest to take it when you wake up if you're not going to eat for a couple hours again. But if you eat right when you wake up, it might be more convenient to take it at a different time of the day. If you do have a limited carb supply, then I do think it makes sense to try matching that carb supply to that tryptophan supplement, because then you get the tryptophan in, you're not adding the competing amino acids from protein, but you do have those competing amino acids already circulating in your blood, and that carbohydrate comes in, brings those competing amino acids into your muscle cells, and gives that tryptophan supplement just a sort of boost its capability a little bit to get into the brain to make it a little bit more effective.
This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Grass-Fed Beef Brain. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements has a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, bone marrow, brain, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com.
This episode is brought to you by Ample. Ample is a meal in a bottle that takes a total of 2 minutes to prepare, consume, and clean up. It provides a balance of fat, protein, and carbs, plus all the vitamins and minerals you need in a single meal, all from a blend of natural ingredients. It's available in original, vegan, and keto versions, portioned as either 400 or 600 calories per meal. I'm an advisor to Ample, and I use it to save time when I'm working on major projects on a tight schedule. It keeps my brain going while I power through the day, never letting food prep get in the way of my productivity. Head to amplemeal.com and enter the promo code CHRIS15 at checkout for a 15% discount off your first order.
The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read and getting early access to the episodes, often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code LITE10 to get 10% lifetime discount.
All right, hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.